What do you think about this year's Gonzaga team? Obviously, last year was a special, special year. But, Tom, as you look towards this year, what are you looking for Gonzaga?
Well, I think what's going to be fun about watching the Gonzaga Eagles this year is their Coach Turner is trying to blend in a couple of younger players into the group of three returning veterans. And he's bringing in some underclassmen, a couple of juniors and a couple of sophomores should see a fair amount of playing time. And, you know, he's been, in the first four games of the season, he's been working on getting the right chemistry out there on the court. And so far, so good. I think the veterans are doing a great job of setting the tempo. And the incoming younger players, as the season wears on, you know, should complement the team very well. And, you know, they were 34-1 last year. They won the WCAC championship, the DC title championship, the Alhambra Tournament Championship. They had three players go on to play Division I basketball programs. So, you know, they've got a tough act to follow, but they've got a nucleus of, I think, a very strong team this year, and it'll be fun to see how Coach Turner mixes and matches these different talents.
As you look to the Bullis side, they are coached by Bruce Kelly, who actually used to coach under Dick Myers at Gonzaga back in the 1980s. Bullis also is defending champion, but of course of the IAC, and they were 19-8 last year, but they also lost a number of starters. So this year they're coming in, they had a huge win last night. They were up in the first quarter 23-10, but actually gave that lead away to St. John's of Massachusetts and actually trailed in the game in the third quarter. However, going into the fourth quarter, they were able to take the lead back and went into overtime and pulled out the win. And Tom, if you want to share just a heck of a story, how they were able to win that game last night by the help of a freshman who was able to hit a couple of big shots.
Yeah, as we understand it, the coach went into one of the classrooms and tapped freshman Joe Hazel, who had only played JV ball, to come on to the varsity program yesterday afternoon in anticipation of the tournament game last night. There were three or four players who were ill, and he stepped in and had a big night. We'll tell you about it in a minute when we finish the national anthem. Okay, Brendan, well, to finish up with that story that I was telling before the national anthem, Joe Hazel was one of the heroes of the game for Bullis last night. He was coming in to sub for one of the starters who had fouled out in overtime and hadn't played the game yet. 20 seconds to go, he comes in and hits a three-pointer, and that got him close. And then with 2 seconds left in the game, he hits another three-pointer, and they win the game by two. So here's a freshman with a lot of playing time ahead of him and had a pretty exciting night for his first appearance at varsity. So we'll see if he gets in tonight.
Absolutely, and we are almost ready for the tip-off here. And for Gonzaga, it will be Ian Hummer, number 52, the huge senior, who will be tipping it off. And then for the Bullis Bulldogs, it will be number 35, Andre Hodo, a 6'5 junior. Gonzaga will be going right to left on your screen, and they are in the home white. And the action is up. Gonzaga actually tips it out of bounds, and it will be Bullis basketball from the sideline. Taking out of bounds for Bullis is number 4, Robert McPherson. He had a very nice game last night and is one of the senior leaders of the squad. Passes it in to number 20, Henry Bernstein. Bernstein up at the top, very good pressure defense by number 25, Andrew Sterrett for Gonzaga, and they force a turnover.
And Tyler Thornton, I think, got in there and forced that turnover. Tyler's committed to Duke and just got in front of the ball before it got to the receiver.
And Bullis also going with a pretty much a full court man-to-man defense. Thornton up at the top, dribbles, looking down low to Hummer, cannot get him, so he puts up a three a little too long. Rebound goes down to Malcolm Lemons, and he gets stripped of the basketball, but it will be Gonzaga basketball.
Yeah, Brendan, when that shot goes up, you see 3 or 4 Gonzaga players under the basket crashing the boards. That's the way they've got to play offense and go for that long rebound.
Cedric Lindsay dribbling way up at the top of the half court. Pass it over to Tyler Thornton on the left side. Lindsay up top looks but does not pull the three. Back over to Lemons. Those three really had a good game last night from deep. Lindsay takes the three
right
and
over,
knocks it down.
Cedric Lindsay right over top of the 2-1-2 zone. So we'll see how long Bullis stays in a zone defense. If he starts hitting from the outside, they may have to pull back to man-to-man.
And Gonzaga's gone to a full court press trying to test this Bullis team out. Bullis breaks the initial press, but then Tyler Thornton with a great play from behind and ties it up with Bullis.
Well, Tyler has made 2 exceptional defensive plays already in the game and just got that turnover. The ball stays with Bullis.
Bernstein to take it out of bounds. It is 3-0 Gonzaga early on in the first quarter here. Nice pass on the curl to number 4, Robert McPherson, but he cannot drop it down. And Thornton picks up the rebound, passes to Lemons. Lemons over to Lindsay for the three. No good this time. And the rebound goes down to Bullis, number 22, Warren Flood, who gets it over to Tex McClinton, number 23.
Warren Flood did a great job of controlling that rebound and muscling through 2 or 3 Gonzaga defenders.
Gonzaga in the man-to-man, but Hummer does a great job of stepping up and helping his man there and stopping the drive. Ball goes out of bounds, literally goes off the court, so Lindsay has to go get it behind a blue awning. And Bullis sets up their man-to-man full-court press. This is quite a thing we're seeing here, that both teams are trying to press early on. Ball in to Hummer. Thornton has the ball, dribbling on the left side, and he breaks the 2-man trap. Hummer goes straight down the middle with all that left hand, but cannot put it home. Lemons does make the follow-up, and Gonzaga has a 5-0 lead, 6 minutes, 20 seconds
Cedric
to go.
Lindsay pulled that rebound down and put it right back up. He took one jump and put it back up. Good position and block out on the rebound.
Gonzaga has a 1-2-2 trap. They're trying to trap Bullis, but they cannot.
Bullis easily breaks that press and gets it down in position. Looks like Gonzaga's pulling back into a little bit of a zone of their own.
Tex McClinton way up top and guarded by Thornton. McClinton breaks the little trap and gets it over to McPherson, but he cannot put it home. Gonzaga the other way, trying to stretch the defense, and look at that, gets all the way, Lemons does, to the rim, but cannot finish. However, Bullis gets the rebound, and they travel, so it'll be Gonzaga basketball.
Number 3, Cedric Lindsay, has just he's really developed into a fine player in the last 2 years. He's a junior, and he's just got a very strong all-around game, very good defense, good instincts.
And now we go back the other way. Bullis gets it down low to Hodo. Hodo puts a very nice move on Ian Hummer, and Bullis is on the board. 5:35 to go here. Gonzaga up 5-2.
Andre Hodo made a great fake on Ian Hummer and just took it up underneath him and put it off the glass.
Thornton drops the ball over to Lemons. Lemons to the hole with the left, and he finishes.
Beautiful drive.
7-2 Gonzaga. Back the other way for Bullis. Bullis going a little bit one-on-one, and it's stripped.
Steal by Cedric Lindsay.
Cedric Lindsay just goes all the way. Great defense
for the Snowbird. And Gonzaga pulls it up to 9-2. And that causes Bullis to take a few minutes to think it over. They're taking a timeout.
I knew what I wanted to do after high school. I just wasn't sure how I wanted to do it. I wanted to go to college for technology, but I also knew that a traditional college just wasn't for me.
So meanwhile, I went from job
to job to job. But none of them were what I really wanted to do. Then I heard a commercial for Westwood College and decided to enroll. I started taking technology classes from day one. And since my instructors were also working professionals, I had the connections I needed to start my career as soon as I graduated.
Start your career with a bachelor's degree from Westwood College. You'll graduate in just 3 years with the tools you'll need to succeed as a network administrator, technical support specialist, systems administrator, or in another great technology career. Visit westwood.edu and learn about the careers and salaries that could be yours with a Westwood College degree. Online.
The radio home of champions, U.S. Sports Radio.
We are back here at the Gonzaga D.C. Basketball Classic, the first game of the semifinal doubleheader. It's Gonzaga 9, Bullis 2. Bullis going down to their side of the court. Gonzaga in a very active man-to-man defense right now. And they knock it away, and that's Tyler Thornton knocks it away, and the ball goes up to Thornton. He goes into the lane, cannot finish, though, and Bernstein comes down with the rebound.
Yeah, he was just a little bit too far outside from the basket when he took that floater, bounced off the front of the rim, and good rebound
Bullis,
by Bernstein.
Bullis really struggling to get into any semblance of an offense right here. Gonzaga's defense just tremendous.
Well, they're double teaming well. They're putting a lot of pressure on the ball, and they're not really leaving anybody open for a clean shot.
Now, and Gonzaga's, if you call it a weakness, they might not have a lot of size, but neither does Bullis, so they cannot take advantage of that. Bullis dribbling up at the top. It's Ryan Wright, but he has it stripped, and then they get it back. Throw up a wild shot, but Bullis does get the rebound. No shot clock in high school basketball.
Yeah, Tex McClinton secured that ball.
Bullis still dribbling around. That's number 22, Warren Flood, way outside of the three-point line. They just simply cannot get into an offensive flow, and it almost looks like they're tired on offense. Ian Hummer knocks the ball away, and Gonzaga comes down.
Andrew Sterrett pulls down that loose ball.
Sterrett fills the lane. Great pass by Lemons, and Sterrett will go to the – well, we'll see. There was a foul on Sterrett. We'll see if he'll go to the line.
It was a nice give-and-go attempt by Malcolm Lemons, and there's too many hands in there, and the ball went off of Bullis.
Patrick Wolf comes into the game for Gonzaga for the first time. So it was not a shooting foul. It will be Gonzaga taking the ball out of bounds. Bullis actually comes in with a number of substitutions, including number 44, Spencer Banks. A little bit of size from Banks. He goes 6'8", a sophomore. Bullis back into a 2-3 zone, trying to slow it down a little bit.
Still 9-2 Gonzaga here at Bender Arena at American University in Washington, D.C.
Lindsay up the top, of the court, looks over to Thornton over the corner, and he goes to Sterrett, who hits Ian Hummer. You know he'll knock down that 10-foot jump shot.
Yep, nice 10-footer from the baseline by Ian Hummer.
Gonzaga drops off their press, but they have the 11-2 lead. We'll see if Bullis can get into an offensive flow because they are really struggling up to now.
It's 11-2 Gonzaga. That was good offensive ball movement that last series for Gonzaga.
Avery Wilmore passes it over to Ryan Wright of Bullis. Wright goes to the lane but cannot finish. And Gonzaga, Sterrett comes down with the rebound and having trouble with the dribble, but he does get through. Over to Thornton. Thornton, beautiful pass. Oh!
Ian Hummer tried a jam and just got off balance a little bit.
What a great pass from Thornton, and I'm sure Hummer will be kicking himself about that one.
Well, he pulled the basketball rim almost down to the floor on that attempt.
And Dowd goes down. Bullis goes down. Number 44, Spencer Banks, tries to put it home, cannot. And it's number 5, Avery Wilmore, who puts it home. 11-4 Gonzaga.
Excellent catch and go by Wilmore.
The other way, Thornton went all the way but could not finish the layup. And so Bullis goes the other way. Thornton was hustling the entire way and actually almost stole the ball, but it will be Bullis basketball.
It's 11-4 Gonzaga Eagles over the Bullis Bulldogs.
And coming back in for Gonzaga is Malcolm Lemons, number 15. He's a dynamite player this year, a junior for Gonzaga.
Andrew Sterrett, senior, takes the bench for a few minutes. He's one of the 5 Gonzaga starters.
Avery Wilmore taking the ball out of bounds for Bullis, struggling with it, and it's picked off
Passed
by Lindsay.
Passed it right to Cedric. Give and go on Lemon.
And 2 points. Lemons has finished with his left twice this game. It is 13-4 Gonzaga, and this really has the makings of quite a showing for Gonzaga.
Brendan, do you recall, is Malcolm Lemons a natural lefty?
That's what I'm going to have to check on because he certainly looks like a natural lefty.
His first 2 shots have been lefty.
We know that Ian Hummer is. Speaking of Hummer, a beautiful block and even better play by number 34, Patrick Wolf, who picks up the charge on Bullis. So Bullis cannot do anything right now on offense.
Got to hand it to Bullis, though. They're taking the ball right at Gonzaga. I mean, they're not afraid of charging right into the basket, and they did take a little charge on that last play, but they're not shy.
Speaking of charging, he and Hummer goes all the way to the lane but does not finish the layup. And then right the other way, Bullis, number 23.
Tex McClinton. Excellent put in.
That was pretty with the right. He went up.
It was about 5 feet from the basket and just laid it up.
13-6 Gonzaga as they slow it down. Steve Turner asked to call a set play and slow it down for Gonzaga.
The younger players are watching. You put that layup off the glass, you got a much better percentage making the basket.
Excellent point. Ian Hummer had great position down low, but had the ball slapped out of his hands. It will be Gonzaga basketball. They'll take it out underneath the goal. Thornton, who just looks so confident this year, and Bullis forgets to guard their man, but Lemons cannot put it home. Out of bounds, and that will actually stay Gonzaga basketball.
Tipped out by Bullis. It's 13-6 Gonzaga.
With about a minute and change left in the first quarter, Gonzaga has the lead here at the Gonzaga DC Basketball Classic. Cedric Lindsay dribbling the ball up at the top and pass it over to Hummer. Hummer thinks of the shot, but thinks better of it for a pass down to Lemons, who could not finish.
There you go.
And yet Patrick Wolf does. So there it is, 15-6 Gonzaga.
Good rebound and finish by Patrick Wolf, senior.
Lemons gets the steal, and he looks ahead. Thornton not open. Now he goes to the corner. Oh, goodness, what a pass. Patrick Wolf could not finish, though. The ball is still in play, although the referee calls it out. If it hits the ref, the ball is still in play, but he was actually standing out of bounds.
The ref almost pushed that one back in for Gonzaga.
Returning from the Bulldogs, number 20, Henry Bernstein.
30 seconds left to go in this quarter, folks.
And substitutions for Gonzaga, number 33, William Saffron checks in, as well as Bernstein comes back in for Bullis. Taking out of bounds is number 5, Avery Wilmore. 15-6 here, Gonzaga in the lead. Bullis passes it over to number 4, Robert McPherson, and he is fouled by Tyler Thornton. And so McPherson will go to the lane shooting two foul shots.
Yeah, McPherson kind of leaned in on that shot and just caught Tyler up in the air. It was a good play. He had a chance of making the basket, but more importantly, he pulled the two-point foul.
You can see the experience there. McPherson is a senior for Bullis, and he's gotten a lot of playing time throughout his career as he hits the first free throw. 15-7, Gonzaga in the lead. 27 seconds left here in the first quarter. Coming back in for Bullis, number 35, Andre Hodo. He's the big man. He actually jumped center to start the game at 6'5". Second free throw good for Robert McPherson. Going the other way, Gonzaga's Lemons brings the ball up and passes it to Thornton, who has 10 seconds, of course, to get it over the half-court line. Taking his time, Gonzaga will probably try to go the entire quarter here.
It's like they're going to hold it for one shot.
That's right. About 12 seconds left right now. Thornton goes into the play, gets into the lane easily, and throws the ball.
Loses the ball.
Wilmore.
Stolen right back by Cedric Lindsay.
Very good.
Big pass on inside to Tyler Thornton.
Excellent way to end the quarter for Gonzaga. And it is 17-8 Gonzaga after one here at the Gonzaga DC Basketball Classic.
Finally, your online shopping solution at Max Malls. Max Malls organizes hundreds of the web's biggest and best stores, making it easy for consumers to find quality online merchants. New stores will be added regularly.
But why wait? Start shopping now at places like Walmart, Sirius Satellite Radio, Tiger Direct, ShareBuilder, The Sharper Image, 1-800-CONTACTS, Drugstore.com, 1-800-PetMeds, and hundreds more.
And the best part, a portion of every sale goes to save the children. So everyone wins at MaxMalls.com.
Come into Glory Days and try their new menu today. With 16 new menu items, such as their zesty boneless wings or their signature Glory cheesesteak, it has never been a better time to make your day a Glory Day. Visit GloryDaysGrill.com for a location near you.
Basketball on U.S. Sports Radio.
And we're back here on the campus of American University, Bender Arena, in the first game of the semifinal doubleheader of the Gonzaga DC Basketball Classic. It's the Gonzaga Eagles ahead of the Bullis Bulldogs 17-8. And, Tom, what did you notice in that first quarter?
Well, I think you're going to see Coach Bruce Kelly for Bullis over there on the sideline. He's exhorting his players to come up with some way to break the Gonzaga pressure and the Gonzaga pressure. I think the difference in the quarter was, you know, the intensity of the defense for the Purple Eagles at Gonzaga, and they're just going to have to find a way to break through it.
And Gonzaga has the ball to start the second quarter. Tyler Thornton way up top, passes it over to Cedric Lindsay, who drives. Beautiful pass to Thornton. Those guys can play two-man basketball.
It was a good give and go from the top of the corner.
19-8, Gonzaga in the lead as Bullis in the blue walks it up the other way. Bullis guard number three, Ryan Wright, dribbles to his right as Gonzaga once again in their man-to-man defense. Wright cannot break his man down, though. Bernstein does. He gets into the lane, takes a jumper, but cannot put it home. And Bullis comes down with a rebound, and that is Ryan Wright with a three.
Pretty shot.
19-11, Gonzaga in the lead. 7 minutes, 10 seconds to go.
You know, that dribble into the paint by Henry Bernstein was a good move. He missed the shot, but it was one of the best shots that Bullis has taken tonight. The long rebound came out, and they converted on the three.
Gonzaga back into their patient offense. Thornton goes down low, goes up for the shot, but has it blocked, and yet he's fouled. He will go to the line shooting two. Thornton, of course, the third team all-league last year, even though he was sixth man for much of the year. He will be going to Duke in 2 years. He's only a junior. Quite a player we're looking at it right here. Tyler Thornton at the line.
Yeah, Tyler went in hard for a layup and had three men on him and somehow was able to muscle the ball up, but he didn't convert, but got two free throws, one free throw left. It was good on the first attempt.
Senior Ian Hummer returns to the game. He got about a minute rest, and he won't see the bench all that much tonight, probably, unless he gets into foul trouble. 21-11, Gonzaga in the lead.
And Gonzaga's got a full court trap going on here, getting ready to. Yep.
Bullis did a good job of breaking it. And then they take a deep three by number 23. Tex McClinton does not go home. Gonzaga the other way.
Long rebound by 52, Ian Hummer, who is fouled on that inbounds pass.
And Hodo fouls him. Hummer just so strong down low. He gets great position and really forced Bullis to have to foul right there. Thornton takes the ball out underneath, gets it over to Lemons, number 15. Lemons over to number 3, Lindsay, up at the top of the key, who swings it back over to the other side. And Hummer takes a fall away from about 9 feet, does not go, but Lemons right there, cannot put it back. Nice rebound by Bullis Bernstein, and Bullis looks the other way. Number 3, Ryan Wright with the basketball right now.
I think Coach Bruce Kelly has definitely stepped up the defensive effort under the basket by the Bullis Bulldogs.
And Gonzaga back into their man-to-man once again. Bernstein goes into the lane. He likes to go left into the lane, and that is a foul on number 33, William Saffron, a hold on Gonzaga.
Will Saffron stepped into his path just for an instant and just enough to draw the foul.
So Bullis will take it out on the side, 21-11 here. Gonzaga in the lead, 6 minutes, 9 seconds to go in the second quarter. Bullis passes the ball into Robert McPherson. He's their big scorer along with Bernstein. Bernstein, number 20, dribbling up top, likes that left hand. Cannot get around Ian Hummer, though. Hummer passes to McPherson, picked off by Gonzaga. Thornton the other way, and that's Lindsay for a three. Good. And it is 24-11, Gonzaga.
Well, Malcolm Lemon was falling over on his left shoulder when he stole that ball and flipped it back to Tyler Thornton, who fed Cedric Lindsay right at the top of the free throw line, and he just nailed the jumper.
And here we go, 24-11, Gonzaga, 5 minutes, 49 seconds to go in the second quarter. Head coach for Bullis, Bruce Kelly, is irate at his team right now. He really feels like their defensive effort, as you've been mentioning, Tom, is not there. Gonzaga, as we know, has such a patient offense, it can be tough to play defense for as long as it's expected against Gonzaga.
Yeah, you know, Brendan, I think part of the problem is that under the basket and on their defensive end of the floor, Gonzaga plays such tough defense themselves. And when they have a steal like that, I don't think any defense has an answer for that, where you've got a fast break and somebody who can shoot the three-pointer from the top of the key.
Gonzaga actually takes Tyler Thornton out of the game for the first time, and they have Cedric Lindsay in there as long as William Saffron, Ian Hummer, Kali Thomas, and Malcolm Lemons. Bullis basketball taking it out on their own end, down 24-11, 5 minutes, 45 seconds to go in the second quarter.
Gonzaga staying in the man-to-man.
And that's Kali Thomas guarding Ryan Wright, number 3 for Bullis. McPherson way up top for Bullis, and another tipped pass. There have probably been seven or eight tipped passes already in this game by Gonzaga's defense.
Well, there have been very few clean passes that Bullis has been able to make inside, and there have been very few open shots and open looks at the basket they've been able to take.
And as a reminder, Bullis did win their league last year, but they lost a number of important players, so they're regrouping this year as well. They have to call a timeout because they cannot get the ball into play. 24-11, Gonzaga in the lead, 5 minutes, 33 seconds to go in the second quarter.
Now we let's see, did he call a timeout or not? He looked like he was making a move for a timeout.
Yeah, we're not sure. Oh, the referees must have called that it was a 5-second violation, and so the timeout was called after that.
He didn't get the timeout in time.
That's right. So Kali Thomas takes it all the way in, but has his shot rejected by Bullis' Bernstein. Gonzaga will have the ball out of bounds. Down underneath Bullis' basketball.
Well, you've got some pretty good speed there with sophomore Khalid Thomas. He came screaming down the paint, threw that ball up, and lost it out of bounds, but still Gonzaga's ball.
Malcolm Lemons passes it to Ian Hummer, who finishes with that beautiful left hand.
It's a textbook Ian Hummer move, spin move inside, one bounce up and in.
What you really notice is he handles his body so well. He's a very physical young man, and it is 26 Gonzaga to 11 Bullis. Bullis passes it over to number 33, David Warren, who cannot go anywhere. Ryan Wright, way at the side, takes a three and nails it. So it is 26-13. They said his foot was on the line. 26-13, Gonzaga. Malcolm Lemons the other way, goes into the lane, cannot finish. Neither can Hummer. Hummer goes back up, and he does score. 28-13, Gonzaga in the lead, 4:40 to go.
Well, Ian Hummer missed the first lay-in, got his own rebound, and put the next one in without any help of the glass or the rim.
Number 23, Tex McClinton, dribbles down low, but passes it over Robert McPherson. McPherson
steps out of bounds.
Stepped out of bounds, so it is Gonzaga basketball. They're bringing back in number 34, Patrick Wolf, a bruising center. He goes 6'4", about 235 pounds.
You know, Brendan, at 28-13, I think Bullis is just frustrated. They can't get anything going on the offensive end, and I think it's mainly attributable. I mean, they're a good offensive team. They showed that last night when they pulled the game out in overtime. But they can't seem to get anything going against this Gonzaga defense. The man-to-man defense is tenacious.
Absolutely. In the first game, you mentioned 64-62, Bullis won last night. Gonzaga restarts their offense. Khalid Thomas getting time to run the offense, the sophomore. He goes into the lane, looks for a shot, then passes to Lemons. Lemons looks down low. Lemons down low there, and he does finish.
Good feed from Lindsay right on the baseline.
And once again, just two beautiful passes. This is a beautifully passing team for Gonzaga. It is 30-13, 4 minutes to go, second quarter. Bullis, on the other hand, goes straight to the rim, cannot convert, and so Gonzaga going the other way. They have numbers. Great pass to Lemons. Hard foul on Lemons. That's Bullis, number 33. David Warren came with a kind of right haymaker on Lemons, and so Lemons will go to the line shooting two.
Yeah. Warren parked Lemons into the stanchion for the basket, and Lemons jumped right back up, ready to shoot his free throws.
It's great to be young. 6'3", 185-pound junior is Lemons. Really having a great year so far for the Eagles, stepping up to take the place of the players who left last year. Hits the first free throw. Gonzaga brings Ian Hummer back, and you just imagine Bullis players saying, oh, boy, he's back. He just controls the lane whenever he wants to.
Senior Will Saffron takes a seat.
Lemons misses the second free throw, almost gets his own rebound, but David Warren for Bullis clears it. In for Bullis now is number 10, Billy Riley. He has the ball immediately stripped. Gonzaga goes the other way. That is Lindsay. Passes it to Hummer. Hummer puts it all beautiful.
Well, it was the Gonzaga Eagles version of the alley-oop. And Lindsay put it about 5 feet above the basket. Ian Hummer climbed up, got it, and dropped it in.
And that makes it 31-13. Gonzaga romping over Bullis right now. 3 minutes to go in the second quarter. Bullis gets into the lane, cannot convert, and Gonzaga, Khalid Thomas going the other way, passes it over to Lindsay. Lindsay tries to get Wolf, but it's knocked out of bounds by David Warren, and the Bullis players look gassed right now.
Well, there is a little bit of a deer in the headlights look out there on the floor on the Bullis Bulldog side. They're just not sure what to do to figure out Gonzaga's defense or how quickly they move the ball on offense.
And you can't discount, Tom, the fact that they played a game last night very late, And then they also were missing two of their players, Ryan Wright and Billy Riley, because of the flu yesterday. So this is a team that is a little bit beat up.
That is going to impact your lineup for sure.
So Gonzaga brings back in Andrew Starrett, who passes to Tyler Thornton back into the game. He says, hello. Two more points for Tyler Thornton. 33-13, Gonzaga in the lead.
Nice feed from Andrew Starrett. Tyler Thornton was under the basket, just leaned up and put it in with his right.
Billy Riley dribbling up top and then passes the ball away for the second straight play, but it goes out of bounds on Ian Hummer's foot, so it'll be Bullis' basketball underneath over on the side.
Well, not only is Gonzaga's defense suffocating, they're quick. They've got quick hands, quick feet. They're anticipating these passes. And I think Bullis, to answer it, they've just got to be a little more deceptive with what they're doing and not look at the guy they're throwing the ball to.
Billy Riley passes it over to Joe Hazel. Hazel, the hero of last night's game for Bullis, hit two threes. He passes over to Billy Riley. Riley dribbles up top. He cannot get away from Khalid Thomas right now. And passes it over into the corner to Hazel. Hazel back up top. They reset the offense. And another steal for Gonzaga. They have numbers. And that's Ian Hummer putting it home. He does not miss this one.
There's the slam. That dunk went in.
35-13, Gonzaga in the lead, and they are just running away from the Bulldogs of Bullis.
Well, you know, we've got to look for a back door or something from Bullis to break this pressure. The up-front, up-top pressure by Gonzaga is stifling, and, you know, one way to beat that, we've seen many teams do it, is you find somebody streaking along the baseline for a back door. They haven't tried it yet, but that's got to be in Bruce Kelly's bag of tricks.
And that was a foul on number one, Tyler Thornton. That's actually his second foul for Gonzaga. He stays in the game with the two fouls with 2 minutes to go in the first half. Bullis will take the ball out of bounds. Number 30, Joe Hazel underneath the basket.
Thornton looks like does Tyler leave. Is coming out, and Cedric Lindsay comes in to replace him.
That's right. And now we have another foul on, it's unclear who it's even on. It looks like it is on Bullis, a moving screen on number 35, Andre Hodo.
Well, I think that's a good play. It was an opportunity to try to set up the back door, something to beat this tough up front defense that Gonzaga's been playing.
Bernstein comes back in for Bullis. Gonzaga will take it out underneath their own basket. Starrett passes it to Lindsay, who brings the ball up against the short press. Lindsay dribbling man-to-man defense. And Bullis trying to trap, but cannot do that. Gonzaga has brought in number 20, Ben Dickinson, for the first time. He holds it up top, resets the offense. Beautiful pass down to Starrett, and Starrett.
Andrew Starrett.
Finishes in the lane, 37-13. Gonzaga in the lead.
Nice 5-foot floater by Andrew Starrett.
Minute 30 to go here in the first semifinal game of the Gonzaga DC Basketball Classic. Bullis trailing the Gonzaga Eagles, 37-13. Bernstein passes over to Joe Hazel, takes a three but cannot hit the three. Starrett with the rebound for Gonzaga in white. And Lindsay brings the ball down court, sets up the offense, passes it into Dickinson, who passes it over to Thomas. Thomas resets the offense. Once again, a very patient attack for Gonzaga. Wolf over to Dickinson. Dickinson tries to get it down low to Lindsay. Cannot get it in, but there's a foul on Bullis. And the foul is on number three.
Ryan White, I think, got
Ryan
that foul.
Wright,
it was a good defensive effort. He just reached in a little too far.
Well, and it was also about a 30-35 second amount of time that they had to play very hard-nosed defense. That's a tough thing for any basketball team to have to do.
Well, Bullis is reaching over and grabbing their shorts and, looking for air.
And so at the line is Gonzaga's Lindsay. Coming into the game for the first time for Gonzaga is number 24, Malik Williams. Lindsay hits the first free throw, making it 38-13 Gonzaga with 1 minute, 1 second to go in the second quarter. Lindsay dribbles, takes his second free throw, knocks that down, 39-13, minute to go here in the second quarter. Gonzaga in white in the lead, Bullis in blue, hoping for halftime to come as quickly as possible. Bernstein dribbles it over to Avery Wilmore. Wilmore passes over to Bernstein, who goes to Hazel. Beautiful
play. There you go.
Play.
There's the back door they've been looking for.
Absolutely. Warren Flood finishes the layup, 39-15. Gonzaga in the lead. Lindsay brings it up for Gonzaga, passes it over to Dickinson. I'm sorry, Starrett.
Coach Kelly's got to be happy about that.
And
there's
Gonzaga,
a steal with a potential dunk coming up. And one.
And they do count the basket for Avery Wilmore. So Bullis gets the steal. A little bit of sloppy play there from Gonzaga. Bullis gets the steal.
Like Sterrett caught him on the arm going up.
And Avery Wilmore behind. Got the basket to go. He'll go to the line to try to get a three-point play. 39-17, Gonzaga in the lead, 24 seconds to go in the half.
Well, you know, Brendan, you can see Coach Kelly over there on the sideline talking to the players that are on the bench. He said, see how well that back door worked? That's what we got to do.
And what also you see, absolutely, is that's coaching going on. This is only their fifth game of the year. Bullis is 2-2 on the year, and so they got to learn, and they have a long time to learn before their championships. Free throw no good for Avery Wilmore, so Gonzaga has 19 seconds left in the half to try to score, but they cannot because Lindsay gets stolen by Ryan Wright, who makes the layup. 10 seconds to go, and Bullis has scored the last five, 39-19. Gonzaga in the lead. Once again, another turnover, and Ryan Wright will have a look
minute
at a
to
three.
Go. Long jumper. Oh, and right through. 30-footer by Ryan White.
Great shot by Ryan Wright, and to be honest,
that'll make him feel better.
39-22 now. Gonzaga was in the lead, 39-13. A 9-0 run in about a minute by Bullis. And so this 39-22 as we go into the
excellent
half.
Excellent outlet pass, excellent release, and good result. We'll see you after the half, folks.
Sports and talk. U.S. Sports Radio. The radio home of champions. U.S. Sports Radio. Reach thousands of prospects this week. U.S. Sports Radio works for your business. Go to www.usportsradio.com and click on Advertise.
Do you take Metro? Do you park in town? Take the Red Line? Why not park at the convenient Rhode Island Avenue Shopping Center commuter lot? Located across the street from the Rhode Island Avenue Metro. Our daily and monthly rates are better than Metro's.
We're on the web at www.danspark.com. That's DANSPARK.com. DansPark.com.
Pick a city, then get a four-star hotel at a two-star price from Hotwire.com. When four-star hotels have unsold rooms, they use Hotwire to fill them. So you get the lowest prices guaranteed.
H-O-T-W-I-R-E, Hotwire.com.
The best travel deals from Hotwire are available at the Million Dollar Scoreboard at USSportsRadio.com.
As he rocks like this.
See at the party. See you at the party.
Do it! Yeah!
We need to hook you up.
Get hooked up this holiday season at Foot Locker. Foot Locker, your first stop.
Shop Foot Locker at the Million Dollar Scoreboard at USSportsRadio.com.
See you at the party. Thanks, Striper.
No problem.
For Dick's Sporting Goods, here's NBA superstar Dwayne Wade.
The great thing about this game is that every year you get to start over. No matter how last season ended, you're back to where you started. At the beginning again. Undefeated.
Shop Dick's Sporting Goods at the Million Dollar Scoreboard at USSportsRadio.com.
For the Nike Hyperdunk, here's Kobe Bryant.
If I were to make a basketball shoe, what would it look like? How would it feel? A shoe should be an extension of the player. It should be built to work with me, not against me. Be as quick as I am, while at the same time, be as strong as I am. If I were to make a basketball shoe, it would be like nothing you've ever seen before.
Find the Nike Hyperdunks and other sporting goods at the Million Dollar Scoreboard at USSportsRadio.com.
Delta Passenger Service Agent Rudy Wilson.
Fine. Big brother taught me responsibility real fast. I take my little sister to ballet, music lessons. I watched her grow up. And boy, a question she had. I didn't have all the answers, but I was there. Maybe that's why I enjoy being a Delta Redcoat. I get a great feeling out of helping people. Only now, I take my daughter to ballet.
Delta, get you there. We get you there with care.
Book now with Delta at the Million Dollar Scoreboard at USSportsRadio.com.
Basketball on U.S. Sports Radio.
Gonzaga class of 1993. It is especially meaningful that Tim is receiving this award because he is the son of our longtime tournament chairman, John McLaughlin. And if you happen to be thinking that perhaps some nepotism is involved, please listen carefully to a summary of Tim's accomplishments and of his lifelong dedication to service to Native Americans and to others. While at Gonzaga High School in the early 90s, Tim began to get involved with service work, working at Some So Others May Eat and in the inner city Zest program. After leaving Gonzaga, Tim graduated with honors from the University of Virginia and later obtained a master's degree at the University of Montana. While at UVA, Tim served as a volunteer in an after-school program for grade school kids and as a mentor in the Big Sibling program. He also did service work in Appalachia and on the Hulatang Indian Reservation in Arizona. Upon graduation from UVA, Tim moved to the Pine Ridge Indian Reservation in Shannon County, South Dakota, the poorest county in the entire United States. There he served as a volunteer teacher at Red Cloud Indian School for 3 years, teaching middle school reading and writing classes and coaching the boys and girls basketball and soccer team. Then, while pursuing graduate student studies at the University of Montana, Tim taught high school English and coached boys basketball on the Flathead Indian Reservation. After receiving his master's degree, Tim took a teaching job at the Santa Fe Indian School in New Mexico, and he's worked there for the past 6 years teaching English and creative writing. In 2003, he created the Spoken Word Club at the school and continues to serve as its coach. His spoken word students have performed in numerous venues and have won many prestigious awards. The club has been written about in the New York Times and was recently featured on the Jim Lehrer NewsHour. It will also be part of an upcoming HBO production about youth poetry. This past month, Tim and two of his students traveled through the countries of Estonia, Latvia, and Lithuania to perform poetry and teach about Native American culture through an exchange program arranged by the State Department. And while many teachers are taking the summer off, Tim and his sister Maureen returned to the Pine Ridge Reservation, conducting a service learning immersion program created by them for Maureen's students at Carmichael Jesuit High School in California. In addition, Tim has also served as assistant to his brother John in the GIVE program, which does service work in the Dominican Republic. Are you beginning to see a common thread among the children of Chris and John McLaughlin? In addition, Tim is a teaching artist with the Santa Fe Arts Commission and also writes for several journals. His manuscript entitled, Is This Good? Writings of the Lakota Youth at Red Cloud Indian Middle School is awaiting publication. For his dedication to and work with American Indian youth, last year Tim was named the 2007 Madison House Alumnus of the Year at the University of Virginia. In recognition of Tim's being honored with this year's Pedro Lupi Service Award, Tim will receive the statue and $500 will be given in his name to the charity he selected, Education Across Borders. Tim, I know this is a great night for you and your Lachlan family, and I believe the entire Gonzaga community and the many communities you have served are extremely proud of the extraordinary service to Native Americans. And Tim is a man of letters, is a published author, is a coach of sports team, and is a man who's crossed cultural barriers. You're certainly a man for others and richly deserving of this award. Congratulations.
Fitness Solutions Personal Training, the number one provider of on-site group fitness for Northern Virginia public schools, is now hiring personal trainers for independent contractor positions. Applicants must be able to present liability insurance, current CPR certification, current up-to-date training certifications, own transportation. Position requires outgoing personalities, comfortable working with 10 to 20 participants, travel to on-site locations, dependability, flexible schedule with a minimum of 2 hours per week available. For more information, please contact Ray Middleton at 571-276-8827. That's 571-276-8827 or log on to www.fitnesssolutionspt.com. That's fitnesssolutionspt.com.
Step up to the plate.
A swing and a drive. Deep left center. Way back. Goal.
Take it to the house.
Harrell back to throw, going deep down the sideline for Robert Johnson.
Oh, my.
You got it. Touchdown. Oh.
And knock it down. With Variuni Creatine micronized creatine citrus. Variuni Creatine is a blended water-soluble form of creatine. Creatine citrus has 90% absorption compared to creatine monohydrate's 40%. Creatine is a naturally occurring metabolite that helps recycle the body's supply of ATP for increased energy output, strength, and endurance. Get yours now. Log on to www.ussportsstore.com. That's ussportsstore.com for Variuni Creatine micronized creatine citrus.
This is Weight Loss Made Simple. Advanced weight loss for those with busy, active lifestyles who want to be healthy, stay fit, and have energy to get through today. Advanced weight loss is the perfect full meal replacement powder. This delicious drink will help you lose weight with 10 grams of protein per serving for lean muscles and enough vitamins, minerals, and calcium to replace any meal. It's so easy to prepare. Just add 8 ounces of skim milk for a perfect shake. Available in 3 great flavors, chocolate, vanilla, and strawberry. For more info on advanced weight loss or to order, visit www.ussportsstore.com. That's www.ussportsstore.com for advanced weight loss.
Making money at home just got a lot easier. Introducing the International Association of Home Business Entrepreneurs. It's an organization that champions the home business lifestyle and provides its members with a multitude of resources designed to achieve maximum home business success. IHBE members receive Book of the Month, featuring titles especially selected for home business owners, audio seminars, exclusive articles on home business topics that matter to you, Magazine of the Month, a full one-year subscription to top entrepreneur magazines such as Fast Company, Inc., Business 2.0, Money Magazine, and more, monthly freebies, money-saving special offers from marketing experts, and more. Check it out now, because making money at home just got a lot easier with the International Association of Home Business Entrepreneurs. Log on now to www.ussportsstore.com and click on the IAHBE button.
That's www.ussportsstore.com and click on the IAHBE button for the International Association of Home Business Entrepreneurs.
This broadcast is brought to you by Nice Offers, money-saving offers and coupons on your favorite merchants, including College Hunks Hauling Junk. Save $30 on a full truckload of junk removal, regular price $4.98. Through this special offer, you pay just $4.68. Download this money-saving coupon right now by logging on to Nice Offers. Go to USSportsRadio.com and click on the Nice Offers button.
Hello. Hey, I went to the Nice Offers website looking for your business because they state money-saving offers and coupons from your favorite merchants. You're one of my favorite merchants. I was looking for you. Didn't see you there. But what I did see was several of your competitors. I don't understand that because it's free to sign up. You only pay for sales. I'll give you one more chance. Why don't you go to USSportsRadio.com and click on the Nice Offers Coupons button.
This broadcast brought to you by NiceOffers.com. Discount coupons and offers from your favorite merchants, including Windows on Washington. Call Windows on Washington today for a free, no-obligation in-home estimate. Don't spend up to three times as much for the same window from our competitors. Full lifetime and transferable warranty. Download this coupon right now by going to NiceOffers.com.
Baryuni Advanced Joint Support contains four of today's best-selling joint health nutraceuticals to promote better joint health, maintain strong muscles and muscle tone, increase connective tissue regeneration and repair, and help with muscular energy, ATP levels, and joint function and mobility. Get Baryuni Advanced Joint Support now by logging on to www.ussportsstore.com.
Get seen, get paid. You can now get paid to drive your car, wear t-shirts, and more. Just join the iEarn Advertising Network and start earning money effortlessly while you go about your day. It's fun, easy, and no experience necessary. Log on to USSportsRadio.com and click on the iEarn button.
The radio home of champions, US Sports Radio.
This is Brendan Farley along with Tom Kelly back here at the first game of the semifinals of the Gonzaga DC Basketball Classic. And we have the Gonzaga Eagles ahead 41-22 over the Bullis Bulldogs. Tom, what did you notice there in the first half?
Well, Brendan, I think the first half was really a highlight film for the Gonzaga Eagles. I mean, the tenacious defense, good execution on offense, and the defense that caused turnovers by Bullis. I think the turnovers were probably in the double digits in the first half by Bullis, resulted in this margin of 41-22. Bullis is trying a lot of different things to break the pressure, and they've had some success underneath the basket, but you know they've got their work cut out for them in the second half. I just think Gonzaga in that first half was a step quicker. They were anticipating the passes better and were taking the ball away.
And before we start to explain, Bullis actually scored the last 9 points of the second quarter, so it is 41-22 Gonzaga as we start here in the second quarter. Ryan Wright dribbles for Bullis, but early on there is a foul on Bullis off the ball. It is number 22, Warren Flood for Bullets, just pushed a Gonzaga player to the floor. And so it's Gonzaga basketball. Taking it out down low as Tyler Thornton passes to Ian Hummer. Hummer goes to the lane. Andrew Starrett with a nice pump fake, tries to finish, cannot, but Lemons gets the rebound. No good. Bullets finally comes back with the rebound and a Gonzaga foul on Malcolm Lemons. Number 15, so it's action-packed, but no scoring here for the first 20 seconds of the third quarter.
Yeah, we start off the third quarter with a couple of turnovers, but let's see if Bullis can keep this 9-0 streak going and get themselves back in this game.
41-22, Gonzaga in the lead, 7 minutes, 30 seconds to go. Third quarter, Ryan Wright dribbles up top, goes into the lane, puts up a prayer, not answered, but Warren Flood gets the rebounds, cannot finish. Out of bounds on Bullis. That is Gonzaga basketball. Tyler Thornton brings it out. Number one down below. Passes in to Andrew Starrett. Trying to break the press of Bullis.
I don't know. It's kind of a half-hearted full-court press by Bullis that really didn't do much. It slowed the ball down a little bit, but Gonzaga didn't have any trouble breaking it.
And Tyler Thornton, a one-man offensive show, goes in, finishes the layup. He now has 10 on the game, 43 Gonzaga, 22 Bullis.
Yeah, Tyler Thornton goes into the lane, looks like he's off balance. He leans in. There's another takeaway.
Cedric Lindsay all the way and lays it off the basket. Cedric Lindsay is having a great game. He had 12 points at the half, now 14 on the game, 45-22 Gonzaga.
Yeah, four quick points off of turnovers by Gonzaga.
Just demoralizing, especially because of the 9-0 run at the end. Bullis thought they had a chance, but now they're down 23. And another turnover.
Another steal by Gonzaga's defense.
Cedric Lindsay all the way, and then passes to Lemons. Lemons off the backboard, and Bruce Kelly, the coach of Bullis, maybe looking for a timeout.
Well, this is like a replay film. All three of those baskets have been from the right side of the glass, an easy layup by Gonzaga. I mean, it's just too easy.
And a 30-second timeout, Gonzaga up 47-22. And fans, I want to let you know that stay tuned after this game because we will have the second game of the doubleheader. It'll be the local St. John's College High School cadets playing Coolidge High School. Coolidge is actually one of the DCIAA favorites this year. They were ranked in the Washington Post top 20. St. John's was not, so this is a nice private school, public school battle coming on up later on after this game.
Yeah, the Coolidge Colts had a good effort last night against Benedictine of Richmond, Virginia, 62-50, coming off of a strong win, a strong fourth quarter. We'll see how they do against a very good St. John's team.
And back here, Bullis, Robert McPherson up at the top, tries to dribble in the lane one-on-one and actually does score. Very nice play, and it's 47-24 Gonzaga.
McPherson stopped right at the elbow, just did a nice stop jump, floated it in.
And McPherson is the leading scorer for Bullis coming into this game, but he has not got on track today. Bullis with the steal. Ryan Wright goes the other way, looking for numbers, doesn't have it, as Gonzaga got back great on defense, and Lemons picks up the loose ball. Foul on Bullis. The foul is on number three, Ryan Wright. Gonzaga will have the basketball out on the side.
Folks, we're broadcasting live from American University Bender Arena.
And Gonzaga with a Tyler Thornton with kind of an alley-oop. Hummer caught it but could not finish. Sterrick gets the rebound, and Gonzaga will go to the line.
Yeah, good jump rebound by Andrew Sterrick. Goes on the line for two. Your announcers tonight, Brendan Farley from the class of 91 at Gonzaga High School, Tom Kelly, class of 68. We're glad to be bringing you this action live from Bender Arena.
And this is the 20th year, Tom, of the Gonzaga DC Basketball Classic. That means 20 years that this tournament has been raising money for charities. Just an incredible situation here at Gonzaga.
Yeah, they've done a great job. I think tonight's turnout sort of validates the fact that it's become a very popular event locally here. We bring in teams from all around the country. We had a team from Fremont, California last year. We've got a couple from New York this year. It's a great way to start the season for all of these teams.
Back to the action. Gonzaga did hit the free throw. Sterrick did. That is Gonzaga 49, Bullis 24. Wilmore into the lane all the way. Cannot finish. And then it's rejected by Ian Hummer, the big senior heading to Princeton after this year.
Ian Hummer went way up for that shot block.
And what you noticed is he also got down on the offensive end and beat his man down, but a nice play by McPherson, number four for Bullis, to knock it out of bounds.
Well, Brendan, Gonzaga, they're out-hustling, they're out-passing, they're out-shooting Bullis in almost every category.
And the thing you look for in a three-day tournament, as Tyler Thornton goes into the lane, cannot finish, but he will get two free throws. Tom, what I was saying, you look at a three-day tournament, and one of your concerns is fatigue. Gonzaga was able to somewhat run away from Mount St. Joe's last night and play much of their bench. And even tonight, there's a real good chance that we'll be talking about some of the bench players going into the fourth quarter. So this should be a well-rested Gonzaga team in the finals tomorrow.
Well, we don't want to get too far ahead of ourselves, but I think you're right. We've got all of the starters out on the floor right now, with one exception. Connor Ford wasn't able to start at center tonight. He's been playing for the last few weeks with an injured wrist and found out yesterday morning it was in fact broken, so he's got a cast from his right hand out to his right elbow, so he's going to be on the bench for a few weeks.
51-24, Gonzaga in the lead as Thornton hit the two free throws, and going the other way, Bullis, Ryan Wright dribbling the basketball, gets fouled by number three, Cedric Lindsay. And Bullis will get the ball out of bounds. 51-24, 5 minutes, 9 seconds to go in the third quarter. Gonzaga in white with the lead.
That's two team fouls on Gonzaga, four on Bullis so far.
McPherson with a deep and tired-looking three. Hits absolutely nothing. and Gonzaga takes the ball back out of bounds.
Well, let's see what Coach Bruce Kelly can do to just infuse some energy into his team for the rest of this game and, you know, try to make a respectable outing out of it.
And he tried a full court press. Gonzaga breaks it, and Andrew Stair takes the three, does not hit it. Hummer knocks it back out, and Hummer goes back into it and hits the 5-foot jumper.
And one.
And the foul. So McPherson with the foul. To be honest, I think he may have to find himself on the bench because it's been a tough last two games for McPherson. A lot of time on the court over the last 24 hours.
Yeah, Ian Hummer took that pass in from Andrew Sterrett. He floated it in from just under the basket about 4 feet away. Left-handed swish. Really a nice soft touch.
It's actually Avery Wilmore leaving for Bullis, and number 23, Tex McClinton, comes back. Hummer going to the line to complete the three-point play. And he does, and
picks
it is
up.
Gonzaga 54, Bullis Bulldogs 24. And since the half, it's been a 13-2 run by Gonzaga. Bullis over to the corner. That's Ryan Wright dribbling on the corner, cannot find a place to shoot. Joe Hazel on the other corner does shoot and nails
shot.
A three, 54-27, Gonzaga in the lead.
Well, Joe Hazel was the young man, young freshman we talked about who came into the game last night at the end of the game and hit a couple of threes, and he made a pump fake against Gonzaga's player. Just put up a smooth free.
And Tyler Thornton gets the nice pass from Lemons down low, and Thornton banks it off the glass, 56 Gonzaga, 27 Bullis. And fans, just to remind you, there are games tomorrow. There are actually four games as all eight teams will once again be playing on the third day of the tournament tomorrow. Bullis, number four, Robert McPherson, had the ball, and they call a foul on
Tyler Thornton.
Number one, Tyler Thornton. That is his third foul. He is, of course, the leader of this team. But with 3 minutes, 59 seconds to go in the third quarter, Gonzaga has the lead, 56-27, so Thornton stays in the game.
Well, Andrew Sterrett stepped in front of that pass and almost pulled it off.
And now Thornton will
ball
lead.
Ball back to Bullis.
Excuse me. Thornton now will lead the game, and Khalid Thomas comes in. Thomas, a sophomore, and Thomas really played some nice basketball in that first half.
Yeah, he really has. Coming in off the bench, I think we're going to see a few more bench players for Gonzaga.
And number 23, Tex McClinton for Bullis, takes the ball out of bounds, tries to get him to McPherson, but Gonzaga knocks it out of bounds, so it'll once again be Bullis basketball.
You know, Brendan, I know that Bullis is losing on the scoreboard right now, but their bench is sitting there. They can learn a lot in this game just by watching how tenacious Gonzaga's defense is and how much they go after the ball and contest every shot.
And as you know, Tom, last year was a very magical year for Gonzaga. They went 34-1, perhaps the best year in school history. And this year they have to find their identity, but you can tell that identity is going to start with offense. I mean, excuse me, with defense.
Well, they're starting that out. They just did a nice give and go and three passes inside there and lost it out of bounds, but it goes back to Gonzaga.
Andrew Sterrett takes it out of bounds, hits Lemon at the top of the key. Lemons travels, though, and to be honest, he probably should have taken that three. It had a wide open three,
yep.
And he's a darn good shooter.
I think he was thinking about the three and halfway through the stroke decided to put it down and dribble in.
But those, once again, that's the learning that goes on early in the year. It's the league play where you earn your fame, and this tournament is exceptional at the beginning of the year, but you really want to be champion at the end of the year.
I could see Coach Steve Turner for Gonzaga make a mental note to talk to Malcolm about that move.
And Ryan Wright with a nice move. He hits a three for Bullis.
Another three-pointer.
And it's 56-30, Gonzaga in the lead, but Bullis is really showing nice shooting touch. As Gonzaga goes the other way, Andrew Sterrett finishes with the right hand. Very nice finish. Very nice play by Gonzaga. 58-30. Gonzaga in the lead. 3 minutes, 10 seconds to go in the third quarter.
Now, that basket by Andrew Sterrett looks like about a dozen of the baskets from Gonzaga. It was 1 foot away from the glass. He just lays it in. Beautiful in pass inside by Malcolm Lemon.
And Bullis passes it back out. Going around the horn, Joe Hazel just hit a three over in the corner, but he dribbles back up top, starts the offense over again. Gonzaga always within 2 or 3 feet of their man, so tough way to play offense when you're playing a Gonzaga team. Ryan Wright dribbles, looks for Joe Hazel. Hazel looking for three, cannot get open, and in fact dribbles it away. But Bullis gets it back. Robert McPherson goes up and is fouled by Sterrett, and McPherson will go to the line shooting two.
That's a good move by McPherson. I mean, he had lost his balance, but he had enough composure to try to put the ball up anyway and at least draw the foul. So he'll go on the line for two.
Earlier today, Archbishop Malloy was not able to beat Benedictine. In fact, Archbishop Malloy from New York, a very storied program. In fact, their coach has over 800 wins, was looking for his 900th win today, but was not able to get it. He may win his 900th game tomorrow in his career.
Well, he's been coaching for 51 years.
Jack Curran.
It's quite a run.
Robert McPherson misses both free throws, and I think I really believe he needs some time on the bench. He just looks gassed out there. Khalid Thomas for Gonzaga cannot get out of trouble, so Steve Turner wisely, the Gonzaga coach, wisely calls a timeout.
30-second timeout for Gonzaga. The teams will regroup.
And so it's 58-31, Gonzaga, 2 minutes 31 seconds to go in the third quarter. Tom, you mentioned earlier that St. John's from Washington, D.C. is a heck of a basketball team as well. They will be playing later on against Coolidge.
Yeah, we watched St. John's last night. They did a great job against Archbishop Malloy, 80-68. They controlled the tempo for most of the game. St. John's graduated a couple of players last year. Chris Wright's playing at Georgetown now. They've still got a deep bench, a good bench. They're bringing in couple of sophomores and a couple of juniors on that squad. We'll see them later this evening.
And of
course, they'll be fun to watch.
If you think about the WCAC, just loaded once again with great teams this year. Gonzaga back to the action and throws the ball away, but Ian Hummer knocks it out of bounds, and it'll be Bullis basketball out of bounds. As coming out of the timeout, Gonzaga was not able to set up a winning play.
So you've got Patrick Wolf on the floor, Andrew Sterrett, Ian Hummer, Cedric Lindsay,
and Khalid Thomas up at the top.
Khalid Thomas for Gonzaga at the moment.
And Hummer goes for the steal. McPherson, though, gets the ball, goes into the lane, is not able to convert. Khalid Thomas for
Gonzaga.
Comes
an outlet.
Nope. Khalid Thomas gets the rebound, gets to Sterrett. Sterrett has a wide open floor, gets it to Wolf. Wolf to Hummer. Oh, what a play. Hummer cannot convert, but that's because Warren Flood of Bullis is draped all over his arms. So Ian Hummer goes to the line, shooting two.
We've been watching Cedric Lindsay for 3 years here at Gonzaga, and one thing he has learned how to do really well is to be running full speed, catch a pass in midair, and flip the pass immediately to the player under the basket. And that was another great example of just excellent ball movement by Gonzaga.
Hummer's not able to hit the free throw. Coming in for Gonzaga for the first time, is Kevin Hogan, a 6'4", 190-pound sophomore. So he's getting into the game, and this is, Tom, what we expected to see is that a three-day tournament, you need to play your bench.
Yeah, Kevin Hogan's a very good athlete. He played a lot of quarterback this year for the Gonzaga football team, and he's going to have a great career.
And he, in fact, gets the basketball back for Gonzaga. He's taking it out of bounds on the side. So Gonzaga in white up 58-31 here. Ian Hummer with the turnaround. Cannot convert it, but Cedric Lindsay catches the ball in midair and puts it in with his back to the basket.
For those of you watching this, and I don't know if you were able to see what happened there, but Cedric Lindsay was under the basket, arching backwards, couldn't see the backboard, and just flipped it up and in. It was just instinct. It's the only way you can describe a shot like that.
And Lindsay does convert the three-point play, so it is 61-31, Gonzaga over Bullis. Minute 50 to go here in the third quarter of the Gonzaga DC Basketball Classic. Bullis the other way, pass to Ryan Wright for a three, and Ryan Wright is just a heck of a shooter. 61-34 now, Gonzaga in the lead, but you cannot take anything away from what Wright shows on the floor. Turnover the other way by Cedric Lindsay. Basically pass it a little too hard, and it goes through the hands of Patrick Wolf. And so Bullis will be coming the other way.
Ryan Wright's going to take a seat after that three-pointer and catch his breath a little bit for the fourth quarter. We've got a minute and a half to go in the third quarter here at Bender Arena, American University, Gonzaga DC Classic.
And Tom, if you think about Steve Turner as he dissects his game, there was a sloppy moment in the last 2 minutes of the second quarter. And now we've gotten a little sloppy here, but other than that, this has been an A-plus effort for Gonzaga across the board.
Yeah, they seem to sense that, they know what each one of their other players are doing and where they are on the court.
And now Avery Wilmore for Bullis is able to get to the lane. Cannot convert, but number 31, Andre Hodo, is able to convert, and so it is 61-36.
Yeah, that was a nice putback by Andre. He had to fight hard for that, well, for two rebounds, really.
And now, going the other way, Gonzaga's Cedric Lindsay is fouled by number 5, Avery Wilmore.
Bullis is in the bonus, so it'll be a 1-1.
Coming in for Gonzaga is number 33, William Safran, and Patrick Wolf takes the seat.
Well, Brendan, while we've got a minute, the purpose of this tournament, obviously, is to help the underprivileged, and Gonzaga raises a lot of money with this tournament for their students to do good works for others at a couple of camps in the summer. And this fundraiser is in its 20th year. There have been a lot of storied players visit this tournament and do very well. The leading scorer of the tournament is Juwan Dixon, who went on to Maryland and then to the NBA. So it's got a rich and deep history, and we're seeing a lot of great action tonight.
And Gonzaga's Cedric Lindsay does convert the two free throws, so it is 63-36 Gonzaga. 30 seconds to go in the third quarter. Bullis trying to hold for one shot, but is not able to, and yet they do take a three. Number 23, Tex McClinton, knocks down the three. 63 Gonzaga, 39 Bullis. 15 seconds to go in the third quarter.
That was good patience that time by Bullis.
And once
again, good ball movement.
Bullis gets the steal. Avery Wilmore passes down low to Hodo, cannot catch it, but goes to Warren Flood, and Bullis is putting on a little run here at the end of the quarter. 63-31, Gonzaga in the lead as the third quarter ends.
We'll be back in a minute with the fourth quarter.
The story of the heart of the champion.
I missed more than 9,000 shots in my career. I've lost almost 300 games. 26 times I've been trusted to take the game-winning shot and missed. I've failed over and over and over again in my life. And that is why I succeed.
Who said it? The legendary icon himself, Michael Jordan. That's what we're looking for, a champion, a heart of pure gold, of pure desire. That's what it takes. You will fail in network marketing over and over and over again. There is absolutely no doubt about it and no way around it. It takes that one final game-winning shot to make it over the hump. And over the hump is everything you've ever wanted in life.
www.bamlmleaderwith.me. BAMLMLeaderWith.me.
Basketball on U.S. Sports Radio.
And we are back here at the campus of American University, Gonzaga versus Bullis basketball. And the first play of the fourth quarter, Gonzaga throws the ball right out of bounds. And so just to reset, this is Brendan Farley along with Tom Kelly here in the Gonzaga DC Basketball Classic. Gonzaga, at their three quarters, has a 63-41 lead over Bullis.
Well, that was an inbounds pass by Kevin Hogan. It was a good lead pass to Tyler Thornton, but just out of his reach, and the turnover goes to the Bullis Bulldogs. They're bringing it up now.
And that's number 10, Billy Riley, bringing the ball up against number 4 for Gonzaga, Khalid Thomas. Billy Riley trying to get the pass over to Joe Hazel on the side. Joe Hazel, a three-point expert for Bullis, but Billy Riley struggled with that pass right there.
For Gonzaga, you've got Will Safran in the game, Khalid Thomas, Kevin Hogan, Tyler Thornton, and Ian Hummer.
And that is a five-second violation on Bullis, so it is now Gonzaga basketball.
You know, Brendan, that turnover was attributable to Tyler Thornton was covering the inbounds pass, but everybody else was doing their job.
And here's another turnover going the other way, so Bullis picks it off, and another turnover, so Gonzaga has the basketball. It's tough to keep up with the action right here when they're throwing it to the other team each time.
Ryan Hogan gets fouled, goes to the line for a 1-1.
And Tom, while we have a minute here, I was going to just point out that the Washington Post Top 20 came out this week. Gonzaga, of course, number 5 preseason after they finished last year number 1. But boy, is this going to be a tough year in the WCAC. DeMatha at number 1, Bishop McNamara at number 3, Gonzaga at 5.
Yeah, it's always a tough league. I mean, DeMatha always brings in a lot of talent. St. John's, who we're going to see later this evening, is always a contender. All of these teams in the WCAC, I think we're seeing more and more the Division I college programs are in attendance, are watching these games, and are looking at these players, and you're going to see a half a dozen or more of these players going to the Division I program each year.
Back on the court, number 22, Warren Flood for Bullis, drives into the lane and picks up a foul on Gonzaga, so he'll go to the line shooting two to reset. Gonzaga in the lead, 63-41 in the fourth quarter here, 7 minutes, 23 seconds to go in the fourth. First game of the doubleheader, the semifinal doubleheader. Later on will be St. John's College High School of Washington, D.C. versus Coolidge High School, also of D.C.
You got Warren Flood. Warren Flood is at the line. He's limping a little bit after that foul, but he swished that first free throw, missed the second.
And Hogan dribbles the ball up for Gonzaga. Beautiful pass down low to number 33, William Saffron, but he cannot compute it, and back up to Tyler Thornton. Number one, over to Hogan. Hogan takes the 15-footer, cannot put it home. Saffron does put it home. 65-42, Gonzaga in the
number lead. 33, Will Saffron can really get up. I mean, he is an excellent jumper, an excellent leaper, and he just got up, grabbed that rebound just below the rim, and put it back in.
And for Bullis, a circus shot by Joe Hazel, but it goes. He actually threw it from behind the backboard, but he made the shot. Tyler Thornton for Gonzaga goes the other way, goes all the way to the lane, but has the ball stripped from him.
It's like he's fouled by Warren Flood.
It actually goes the other way, Tom. Thornton actually pushed Flood after the play, and so Thornton now has four fouls on the game.
Picks up his fourth.
And he has to leave with 6 minutes, 42 seconds to go. We'll see him again in this game as Gonzaga now has a 21-point lead, 65-44.
Well, Tyler Thornton is playing with abandon tonight. You don't usually see him fouling out of games, and he's picked up four already. I think he's just enjoying himself.
Heading the other way for Bullis, it is Bernstein, passes it in to Tex McClinton. McClinton up at the top of the key, dribbles twice, goes over to Hazel. Hazel is really feeling it but cannot knock home the jumper. Gonzaga goes the other way. Khalid Thomas dribbling it up, now playing the point in Thornton's absence. Now over to Hogan. Hogan getting some extended time here in the second half. Passes it, unfortunately, too hard for Saffron. And Hogan, who is the quarterback, has that strong arm and throws it out of bounds. Bullis basketball.
And you got Malcolm Lemon coming in to relieve Brian Hogan.
For Bullis, it is McClinton taking the ball across the timeline, dribbling the top of the key. Looks like he wants to drive, pulls up, does not take the shot, does give the backdoor pass to McPherson. And they call a traveling on McPherson. Very frustrated right now because I think he felt like he was fouled.
Well, and I think he just needed one more dribble to get an open shot there. And couldn't quite put it together.
All right, Lindsay all the way to Hummer. Hummer goes into the lane. Acrobatic layup. It is good. 67-44. Gonzaga in the lead.
Excellent pass by Cedric Lindsay to Ian Hummer, streaking down court. They've done that before. We've seen that play many times before.
Yes, we have. McClinton over to Bernstein. Bernstein, a lefty, dribbling to his right and almost has it stolen going in his opposite hand. McPherson over to Bernstein. Over to McClinton for three, and they love that corner. 67-47, Gonzaga in the lead.
Really not a bad strategy, Brendan, when you think about it. They're trying to drive the ball inside and then flipping it to the outside for the long three. I mean, how else are they going to catch up in this game?
Lemons, baseline jumper. Very good. 69.
Malcolm Lemon from about 12 feet. He's got a very, very soft release.
69-47, Gonzaga in the lead. About 5 minutes to go in this game. Pull-up jumper by McClinton. No good. Khalid Thomas starts the break again. Does not have numbers, so wisely pulls it out for Gonzaga. Gonzaga in the white. Great pass down to Saffron down low. And he converts, and so it is now 71-47 Gonzaga.
I don't know where Cedric Lindsay was looking. I think he was looking up in the stands, but that no-look pass went right under the basket to a wide-open Will Saffron, and he just gently laid it in.
And there we have a timeout by Bullis. It is a full timeout. Gonzaga in the lead, 71-47, 4:51 to go in the fourth.
Signal Financial is a cooperative owned and operated by its members. This is what distinguishes the credit union from other financial institutions. Members put their money in a variety of savings accounts, and that money in turn is lent to members. At Signal Financial, we strive to provide quality and fair price financial services for our membership. For more information on Signal Financial Services, call 301-933-9100 or toll free 800-368-0108. Or log on now to sfonline.org.
As he rocks like this.
See you at the party. See you at the party.
Do it!
We need to hook you up.
Get hooked up this holiday season at Foot Locker. Foot Locker, your first stop.
Shop Foot Locker at the $1 Million Scoreboard at USSportsRadio.com.
See you at the party. Thanks, Striper.
No problem.
We're back here in the Gonzaga DC Basketball Classic. Gonzaga in the lead, 71-47 over Bullis. 4 minutes, 50 seconds to go in the fourth quarter of the first game of the semifinals. Back the other way, Bullis in blue has the ball stolen by Khalid Thomas. Thomas dribble
good
drives.
Good anticipation on that steal by Khalid Thomas. He just reached in and stepped in front of the pass.
And Bullis in a man-to-man defense, but Gonzaga running beautiful plays. Khalid Thomas cannot get to the lane, knocked out of bounds. Still stays Gonzaga basketball. And if we just to recap the game, Tom, Gonzaga really started out strong, had an early lead. Bullis tried to fight back, but by the half it was already Gonzaga 41, Bullis 22.
Yeah, and it stayed about a 22-point game after the end of the third quarter.
Khalid Thomas over in the corner, dribbles out of trouble, over to Lindsey. Lindsey wisely takes time on the shot clock. Instead of trying to pour it on against Bullis, he wants to run some time off the clock.
Looks like a zone by Bullis.
And Lemons with a sweet little jumper from the baseline. He is about, that was about an 8-footer, but he really controls that baseline. 73-47 Gonzaga.
Malcolm Lemon just did a quick jump fake at the 3-point line, dribbled in 2 steps, and floated the 8-footer in.
And Warren Flood goes into the lane, and beautiful pass to Robert McPherson, but McPherson cannot compute. Warren Flood gets the rebound, cannot put it in, and it's Gonzaga the other way. Once again, Lindsey goes to the hole and does make the layup, 75-47.
Well, Ian Hummer was paying Cedric Lindsey back for the pass he gave him. That was a beautiful bounce pass feed underneath to Cedric, and he just gently put it in
and
off
the
glass.
And I think Hummer might have taken a look and noticed that he'll probably be out of the game the next dead ball as some of the Gonzaga bench comes in, so he wanted to have a little fun at the end of his time on the court.
Well, they're moving the ball well. They're passing. Well, there's a steal by Cedric Lindsey going full court.
Just quick hands. He was able to get the crossover that McClinton was trying to put on him. Lindsey reached in, and McClinton had to foul.
Brendan, one of the things we're seeing here, one of the big differences in these two teams is that Gonzaga's hands are all over the ball on defense, and you don't see that kind of tenacity from Bullis yet. They're really not trying to slap the ball away or go after the ball. Gonzaga's doing it almost in every possession, and, you know, I think the results will speak for themselves. They've got at least 20 turnovers by now.
And Lindsey at the line shooting two. They called it a shooting foul. He makes the first one, and we have mass substitutions. For Gonzaga, number 10, Danny Williams makes his first appearance, as well as number 15, Malcolm Lemons is back in the game. Number 20, Ben Dickinson. And number 23, Azani Pinckney into the game for the first time.
Yeah, Brendan, it looks like it may have been a foul on the floor, but Bullis is up to over 10 fouls now, so every situation is going to be a two-shot foul. Gonzaga's got 16 fouls.
And they did convert, so it is Gonzaga 77, Bullis 47, 3:10 to go here in the fourth quarter. Billy Riley dribbles to his left against his number-sake, Danny Williams, number 10, and Bullis restarts the offense, Warren Flood up top. Riley has really struggled today. I think physically Gonzaga has been tough for him to play against. Warren Flood up at the top, dribbles into the lane, gets a nice head of steam, and he's fouled.
Like a foul on the floor, and that'll bring a one-on-one for Warren.
And that, I believe that foul was on number 23, Azani Pinckney, for Gonzaga. So Warren Flood, who the Washington Post notes is one of the IAC, the Inter-Athletic Conference's preseason first-team players. Flood goes to the line, shooting a 1-1. Misses the first one, and Tyler Thornton, who just came back into the game, gets the rebound.
It's like Tyler's going to run the offense for Gonzaga for the last few minutes of the game.
Passes it over to Lemons. Lemons up top. And that is Danny Williams. Danny Williams over to Dickinson, and Gonzaga once again, even though they have three players off the bench, run a beautiful offensive set. And that's Ben Dickinson with the layup.
Well, Ben Dickinson's a tall man. He's a sophomore, 6'7", and he went up and just laid that in softly.
And Clinton for Bullis hits the three. And without the three-point shot, Tom, Bullis really would be way out of this game. As it is, they are down 79-50, 2 minutes, 5 seconds to go in the game.
Yeah, I think we're going to see their three-point percentage is going to be very respectable in this game. They just haven't been able to put anything else together.
But from a Gonzaga perspective, I think strategically they were going to allow that as long as their defense was strong in the middle of the floor. Gonzaga gets the ball back. Dickinson takes a nice dribble, shoots the ball, does not make it, and Bullis gets the rebound. Billy Riley trying to push it up, does not have numbers, and is stolen from behind, but they call a foul on Gonzaga. And realistically, that might be a little bit of an ill-advised foul, because the benefit was not there.
Right. Well, Brendan, we talked earlier about hands on the ball, and that's what's got to be frustrating. So frustrating for Bullis is that every time they're dribbling the ball, they've got a hand in their face or a hand on the ball.
Malik Williams comes back into the game for Gonzaga as Billy Riley, number 10, goes to the line.
Yeah, that's 18 fouls for Gonzaga, and I think we've got a count of 12 for Bullis this half.
Riley, a sophomore out of Potomac Falls, goes 5'9", shooting his second free throw, and he does make it. It is 79-52, Gonzaga in the lead, minute 40 to go in the game. Bringing it up for Gonzaga is number 10, Danny Williams. Passes it over to number 23, Azani Pinckney. Pinckney over to Tyler Thornton. Thornton to Dickinson. And ball passed out of bounds by Malik Williams as Dickinson had cut to the hole. A very good thought by Williams. He just threw it a little bit too high. For Bullis, going the other way, Billy Riley brings the ball up court against Danny Williams. Riley trying to find room, but he just has not been able to get much headway today. Another steal by Gonzaga. Malik Williams all the way in, and he finishes.
Coach Turner for Gonzaga has got to be very happy with the way his players are just going after the ball at every possession.
And if you look at the high school level, sometimes you notice some players are just better than others, but what we're seeing really here for Gonzaga is such a well-coached team because we're bringing players off the bench, and they're running the offense so well.
And they're still going after the ball.
Absolutely. So Malik Williams goes to the line, and he makes the free throw. That is a three-point play. Gonzaga in the lead, 82-52. A minute and change left in the game.
Number 24, Malik Williams, is going to be a good prospect. He's a sophomore. He's got a real good free throw stroke.
And for your old University of Maryland fans, he's the son of Buck Williams.
Absolutely.
The former Terp.
So he's got a lot of good basketball genes.
For Bullis, they try to get onto the board again. Kyle Middleton, number 15, misses the three. Tyler Thornton brings it out, now goes in, and is not able to finish, but Ben Dickinson isn't able to finish either. So Bullis tries to get the rebound and does.
Controlled by Bullis.
And Kyle Middleton brings it up, gets it to Riley. Riley over to Wilmore. Wilmore no good on the three, but Kyle Middleton finishes.
Nice catch and shoot by number 15, Kyle Middleton.
And Bruce Kelly, the coach of Bullis, has his players playing up to the final buzzer. Very impressive performance by Bullis to hang in there in a tough night.
Yeah, 15 seconds to go. Gonzaga looks like they're going to be content to just move the ball around, pass the ball around, and not add to the 82-54 score.
And so that will be our final here in the first semifinal game of the Gonzaga DC Basketball Classic. The host school, the Gonzaga College High School Eagles, knock off the Bullis Bulldogs 82-54, and they await the winner of the second game between St. John's and Coolidge.
Well, it was a fine effort by the Gonzaga Eagles. They put some extreme pressure on the ball the entire game. They move on to the championship game tomorrow night at 6:15 against the winner of the next game. And I think everybody up and down, Coach Turner's got to be happy with the way all of his players performed tonight.
Absolutely, and Gonzaga moved to 4-1 on the year. As we said, they were preseason ranked number 5 in the WCAC, but they were beaten by the 6th-ranked team, O'Connell. So there's a chance that they'll move down in the rankings, but what is entirely clear is this team is a fundamentally sound team, plays very good defense, passes the ball around, and really seems to enjoy playing basketball together.
Well, the other great thing about these early season tournaments, Brendan, is that Bullis, while, you know, the score didn't indicate that it was a very close game, Bullis had an excellent workout tonight. They got some experience against a very good team, and that's going to help them in their league when they go back and compete in the teams that they're used to playing with.
Absolutely, and as we mentioned earlier, Bullis was the IAC champion last year as they finished 19-8. So an excellent start to the semifinals of this tournament. A huge crowd here at Bender Arena on the campus of American University. But we will go to a break here as we wait the next game between Coolidge of Washington, D.C.'s Public League and St. John's High School of the WCAC. For Tom Kelly, this is Brendan Farley signing off.
Very good.